Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to land in Power BI job. The answer is very simple. It is a journey. And I'm going to explain how this journey should be planned. This topic is very special to me because those who are learning from this channel, they are acquiring the technical knowledge because this particular channel contains 150 plus videos in Power BI that covers almost 95% of them. Already a lot of people got job out of it. But for some of them, or I can say most of them, they can easily acquire the technical knowledge from this channel. But the point where they're stuck is like, they're not sure where to apply for a job, where the opportunities are available. So that gap I want to bridge in this video. If you are new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin our today's topic. So how to land in Power BI job. The prerequisite is like you should have technical knowledge, as I mentioned before, and you might have prepared the resume first, right? These are two prerequisites. Once you are possess the knowledge, then you prepare the resume. So I want to pass a moment here. Like, you see like data analytics or Power BI as a future, and you are a fresher or experience, or you want to switch to different domain here, right? But as soon as you see it, you just prepare your resume and update it in the portals, and you will not get a job because you will fail in interviews. The thing is, like as I said before, it's a journey. First, take some time, at least 1, 2 months, 3 months, to prepare yourself for the technology. You need to be familiar with the technology. Then you prepare your resume, right? These are the two prerequisites. That takes 1 to 3 months based on your capability. Next, there comes how to land, right? How to, where to search. That is what main focus. The first thing is like job portals. The portals I mentioned here, Naukri and Monster, belongs to India. And Indeed is global. So the job portals is the first step you need to look at, right? Once you prepare your resume, you post your resume over there. So Naukri is my famous, it is so famous and it's my favorite too. So you should update your resume on a regular basis. Once you upload, you just should not leave it. You keep updating some changes in your data. Information, so that it will keep your resume at the top. And also mention details like notice period if you're working and actively looking for a job, or this you are interested in the technology. And as most of the recruiters in India, they prefer, they look their resumes or profiles from the Naukri websites. So I personally prefer, your first step is to, once you prepare the resume, you need to upload in the job portals. Then there comes social networking sites like LinkedIn and other social media. First, we'll talk about LinkedIn. That is one of the best platforms and famous job portals, as many people across the globe are connected, and you can have opportunity to connect with the HR recruiters are people from the same area of interest. So you will get a job opportunities through HR, which are your connections, right? So people from your field also, they will refer some jobs. So as soon as you connected with your focus or field of interest people and HR, once they have some job opportunities, they will keep posting in LinkedIn. I hope a lot of people, if you say out of 100 people, everyone will put the resumes in Naukri, but at only 10 to 15% of people use the LinkedIn or other social media for posting their resumes. So here it's a LinkedIn. It's not you, once you log in, you post your resume over there. It's basically you need to interact with your connections. And once you get an opportunity, you can keep applying. And that is in LinkedIn, you have a job portal as well. There will be jobs are listed, you can apply it as well. So This is what I said. This will not happen as soon as you join in LinkedIn, you will get an opportunity on the next day, right? It takes time. Then there is a personal reference. This is most of the people are missing, like your friends, ex-colleagues and classmates. You should inform that you are looking for a job. I often feel like people, once they start searching for a job, they will keep it as a secret thing. And only if they get after getting the offer, they will reveal it. I'm pretty much not sure why they are doing it. It's up to them. But once you say like you are looking for a job and you see like a lot of people you are conveying, if you have any opportunities, you can let me know. Then that will also help, right? Because some countries, they are close. I mean, the job market is not open as in some countries. So you should say or ask people with your friends or ex-colleagues or your classmates. Just remember all those people and keep calling them and say that you are looking for a job. That may work sometimes. And another important thing is like company websites. So company websites, it's like you check for some companies, those who do data warehousing or Power BI reporting, and you can start applying it. So because I'm saying all these things, it's not only applicable to Power BI, whatever technology you are working on, the same step you can follow. So you see some of the companies, so how you can know this company is using Power BI? Using LinkedIn or some other personal reference, right? They say like I'm working in my company also working. So just check their websites. If it's available, you just go and apply through their company website, because some companies, they don't post it in job portals. They will post it internally. And if there is no internal people available, you can be called for an interview. The final tool that everyone can use is like Google, as you can start searching for Power BI job. So mostly when you search in a Google, mostly it will appear on most of the job portals or LinkedIn, then your company websites will appear. So if this is like you are searching for a company and you go and apply for it in Google, if you the company portal has listed, I mean some of the things, some companies you might have missed, right? So once you Google it, that will appear. So these things, you need to do it regularly, right? It is not like once you created your resume, upload it in Naukri, you will get call automatically. So just keep doing it repeatedly until you get the calls or crack the interviews. So this is a journey. Usually it takes 3 months to 6 months, right? From preparing, once you already have a knowledge, then the preparation time will be reduced. Only the job search that will happen in 1 or 3 months. But if you are newly starting your career in Power BI, you don't know Power BI, then at least it takes 3 to 6 months for you, right? So this is what my advice. So you cannot get a job as quick as possible. Do all these things regularly without, or daily, I can say. Keep connecting with your contacts. And one last point I want to highlight here is, don't go to LinkedIn and say like I need a job. You connect to every connection and say like I need a job here, right? Don't do that. Just apply for the job portal in LinkedIn, but connect to HR managers or data analysts or Power BI developers, whoever in the LinkedIn. Then once they post it, you can apply it. Okay, that is a culture you need to follow. And other social media, I can see is like in Telegram and other WhatsApp groups also people are posting the job, but we don't know the how trustworthy it is. But once you join those groups as well, Telegram, but I will not recommend this, but you can try it. Trying doesn't mean that it will affect you, right? So try those mediums as well, but that is my last preference. But if you get a chance, then you can use it. It's going to change your life. I hope you like this video. Hit the thumbs up button and press the bell icon for notification. Comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.